Austin. I'll make a bad game.
Charlie, what the hell are you doing? It's like 4 a.m.
I need you to talk about Saw for like 5 minutes.
Alright, that's easy.
Don't show any more.
Shit.
Is Saw a masterpiece? It certainly holds a great deal of significance in the entertainment industry, but is it really justifiably a masterpiece? In this video essay, I'll talk about how the production and reception of the Gore Fest of Saw holds the answer to this question. And yes, the skit at the beginning was written and shot well before the rest of the script was made. Please, enjoy. The most impressive thing about Saw is how much money it made relative to its cost. The average estimates take the $1 million budget, which was incredibly low for a big Hollywood movie at the time, and blows it up to a whopping $100 million gross. That's some cold hard cash. Not only did Saw flip around $1 million, but it also revolutionized the horror genre as a whole, and movies to this day continue to be inspired by what Saw did. A book of the movie, and the entirety of the main plot following John and Dr. Gordon, takes place in a single set. The film was reportedly filmed in only 18 days. Apparently there was so little good B-roll that stills of newspapers and images were used in montage for the same effect, and honestly, it actually worked better than any real B-roll would have. All of these methods effectively turned a little indie darling into a solid horror film that audiences ate up. But cost-effectiveness alone does not make a film a masterpiece as much as it does a good investment. No, the real beauty of Saw was how much it changed its own genre for years to come. You see, before Saw, the concept of a horror film was to place the audience in a situation where they could feel like they were being chased, a sort of proximal emotional roller coaster. But Saw changed this formula entirely. Instead of being chased by a killer, the victims were caught long before the camera began to roll, both within the film itself and, well, the film itself, giving a different sense of claustrophobia. It's not about getting caught in of itself, it's about what happens once you get caught. Not only that, but through flashbacks you get to see what has already happened to those who were caught before. Speaking of flashbacks, this movie makes good use of them. While the franchise would eventually take this to an extreme level, the first movie does a good job in using flashbacks to fill in plot holes introduced in the main story arc. Arguably the most brilliant instance of this is where at the very end of the movie, the opening shot plays again. This time, with the context that the keys falling into the bathtub means that John will die. There are other similar scenes that play into the same concept of filling in the gaps as well. It's also worth mentioning how much of an icon this movie has become.
Hello, I'd like to play a game with you.
Is probably the most quotable catchphrase in the genre, apart from maybe,
"Here's Johnny!"
Imagery from Saw has been parodied and paid homage to in several different shows and movies, and the same claustrophobic elements can be seen in modern horror all across the board. In terms of modern horror, Saw pretty much set the bar on every standard. Oh yeah, Saw is also really gory. Infamously gory. I already said that I wouldn't show any of it, but it is worth mentioning. I'm not sure why, but people really love seeing other people turned inside out, and Saw certainly provides on that front. With all that, can it really be classified as a masterpiece? Well, yeah. Why not? While it might not be the most prim film of all time, its contribution to the form is incredibly important. The typical definition of a masterpiece includes a reflection of the time made. And although we may not consider 2004 terribly far away, Saw had such importance on that time, and times to come, that it's hard not to call it a reflection of the time. Is it the greatest production ever? No. Does it have the best writing? Not by a long shot. But it is significant culturally, and as such, should be considered a masterpiece.